Hi everyone, I'm Cody at W3AMG with BridgeCom Systems, and today we're going to be showing you how to install a premium BridgeCom Codeplug, such as the Super Codeplug or the Ultra Codeplug. Let's get into it. All right, so first things first, we've got our radio here brand new. Go ahead and fire it up. We're gonna take our programming cable, plug one side into the computer, and plug the other side into our radio. Now at this point, we can start installing our Codeplug. So over here on the computer, make sure you have the latest software for your radio. If you don't have it, you can go to bridgecomsystems.com and go to the support tab. From there, you'll be able to download all of the software you need for your radio. For this, we just need the CPS. So go ahead and open that up. While that's going on, there we go. We have the CPS opened up. We also need to get the Ultra Codeplug. If you don't have a Super Codeplug or an Ultra Codeplug, totally worthwhile. It will save you hours, and probably even days worth of work. It took us about 2 months to build the Ultra Codeplug. There's over 800 different talk groups in it, and it took so much time to compile it and put it together. You can skip all that, bypass it with one of these Codeplugs. So we have our Ultra Codeplug here. And if we open it up, there's different versions for different radios. So let's go ahead and get started. So I've got my CPS open. First thing you want to do is go to File and then Open. Now from here, we can find our Ultra Codeplug. There it is. We'll open that folder up and then find the right version for our radio. So in this case, we know it's an 878UV2. It's got that green button on top. 878UV2, 8782 there. We'll open that. Give that a minute to open. Awesome, there we go. It loaded, we're good to go. Now at this point, you just want to add a little bit of your own information to it so it actually works. Go to the digital tab and click on radio ID list. In here, you'll have just a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Go ahead and put your radio ID in there and then name and call signs. There we go. And you're pretty much set. At this point, go ahead and make sure your radio is plugged in. Click on the COM port settings, which it is. At this point, write to the radio, click OK. You do want to go ahead and check the digital contact list. Keep in mind, this will take a while if you do that. For the sake of today's video, we're going to skip over that, but you definitely want to check that if you're writing this to your radio for the first time. If you're just making changes after the initial writing to your radio and you're not updating the contact list, you can uncheck that and it will save you a lot of time, like in today. So go ahead and click OK. There we go, write data complete. And at this point, wait for it to finish. There you go, unplug that radio, and we should be ready to rock and roll. And check that out, we have the entire Ultra Codeplug in our radio now. We can go through all those different zones, look at all those countries in there. We can go through, let's say Canada, for example, we can scroll through Canada. You have all the different provinces, all the areas. It is very, very neat, all of the different talk groups in the Ultra Codeplug. Now keep in mind, you can see in the CPS, the frequency is 446.550. So when you set up your hotspot, make sure to put that frequency in, 446.550. I love it. This thing is awesome, and you can have it too. Now it is completely set up to use with your SkyBridge. Now if you want to use this with a local repeater, we have another video that will show you how.